Samoans and Pacific people were the worst people in the world. I wish I wasn't Samoan. I couldn't aspire to be Pacific and to be successful. I think to be white was to be successful. Welcome to Aotearoa Lover. Josiah is my name. I live here in Ototahi in Christchurch. I'm Afkasi Samoan. My dad's from Apia in Samoa and moved to New Zealand when he was 17. And mum's a European Australian and she moved to New Zealand just before she was 5. When I was a kid, very few Samoan people, very few Pacific people that I could see around me. I felt really embarrassed about being Samoan because of the statistics that I saw on TV. I remember one of the most influential shows on TV at that time was Police 10-7, and pretty much the description, 22, brown, Māori or Pacific, that's all I could see Samoan people, Pacific people were. So yeah, this is Parklands. I can't remember when we moved here, but it must have been like when I was about 6 or 7 maybe. We would all sort of play together on the streets, really our playground. Definitely as a kid, I participated in the racist jokes that other people would say about other people. And made jokes about my own communities. And I guess I looked at the stats and the stories that people told about us and couldn't see anything worth trying to cling to, and so joined the majority. I look at that now and think that was, yeah, I wish I had the courage to not have done that. When I was 14, there was a really big event here in Christchurch called the Pacific Youth Parliament, and me, as someone who hadn't accepted that I was Samoan at the time, it's kind of probably a bit strange that I put my hand up, but it was my mum who encouraged me to go for it. That was amazing, to suddenly feel completely embraced, completely accepted for who I was. It didn't matter that I hadn't had the opportunities to learn about my Samoan heritage or our Pacific communities when I was a kid. Now I had all these new friends, you know, who were Fijian, who were Tongan, who were Samoan, who were Niuean, and I guess beforehand I couldn't even really say I had one Pacific friend, so that was huge. Changed my life. I made these new friends who were Pacific, and we started this charity to increase Pacific youth voice in our city, and then we started to hear from Pacific young people that the biggest problem was belongingness. Like 60% of us are born in New Zealand, and to be born in New Zealand means, you know, you come with not necessarily clarity on how we're supposed to fit in here. Suicide was a big challenge for Pacific young people. More Pacific young men die by suicide than by road accidents. We started to host a couple of events so that we could help teach Pacific young people who might hear really horrific stories from their friends, know how to respond. Because, I mean, how do you respond when someone comes to you and says, I'm thinking about taking my life? How do you talk about those things to young people? As I finished school, I got this $20,000 law scholarship, and so I decided I was going to study law at university. In my first year, I did really well. Second year, midway through the year, I had quite a significant breakdown. I struggled to get up in the morning. I struggled to leave the house. And I ended up dropping out of uni. So for 6 months, I was re-nourishing myself with my family, so trying to get back into routines, trying to do what I loved, you know, like playing with Lego. History has always been one of my passions. One of the things I collect is military uniforms. This is like an American Air Force jacket, former like 1950s New Zealand electrical engineer's uniform. Yeah, I kind of am just interested in these things which speak of the past. So this is something I saved. It's like a copy of old newspapers from 1953. And so in 1953, a number of important things happened in the world.
Edmund Hillary climbed Everest with Tenzing Norgay.
But the one that really stands out is when the Queen was crowned. I'm not a royalist, but I'm still interested in the key events that shape the world. I collect the stuff because I get nervous that people forget about the past. I got a call in February 2018. The New Zealand government had asked if I would be interested in being on a panel doing this big review into mental health and addictions. The biggest review in 22 years and the biggest review in New Zealand's history. So the government chose six of us. One of them was Sir Mason Jury. He created this model which a lot of people use every day called Whare Tapa Whā, which still talks about the pillars of life. And then other people like Professor Ron Patterson, who was an ombudsman, Dr. Jemaine Tiatia Seif, who's a huge Pacific academic. So how do I share the voices of children, youth and young people amongst the most amazing leaders? They made it really easy. They were so inclusive. While I was 22 and while I was a student, it wasn't just for me to ensure that children, young people, students' voices were heard, that actually they had a responsibility to do that too. All of us carried all of it. I've found that we're at our best when we're partnered with Kaumatua. If we're not getting enough younger people alongside our current leaders learning about the way things are happening now and then together shaping what could be, it won't take long before we don't have the pipeline of the next people. Finding your identity is one of the most important things I think we can do in our life. If we don't love who we are, or we don't love our heritage, it can make our journey and the opportunities we have much more reduced, because we aren't willing to draw from or to be part of a side of our life. So for me, continuing on the journey to be comfortable in all of who I am is me feeling free, I guess.
Supporting local content so you can see more of New Zealand On Air.